For part two, we'll be discussing graphing quantitative data, or numerical data. So, to illustrate this, we're going to look at a sample of 100 new cars. I believe this study was published by the EPA, but to be honest, I just stole this example from your textbook. So you have access to this data set as well. So it's just 100 different new cars, and this is the MPG ratings. And so this 100 numbers here is a little hard to envision or really visualize. So to visualize this data, we'll be looking at dot plots, stem and leaf plots, and histograms. And these are just three methods for graphing quantitative data or numerical data. One way to do this is something called a dot plot. A dot plot is you just break down, in this example here, here's a number line, and each of these, we break this down this number line into intervals of 0.5 of a width. So in other words, this dot here are all the vehicles that have a mile per gallon rating between 30 and 30.5. And then if there was a dot next to it, it would be 30.5 to 31, etc. So as we can see here, there appears to be three dots with fuel efficient ratings of 35.0 to 35.5. So that tells us a little bit of information, and mostly we kind of get a shape, and we see that most vehicles seem to have a fuel efficiency around maybe 37, 38. That seems to be the high point, and it seems to have like a one hump type shape. And then there's this one vehicle all the way out here at 45. One thing I do notice here also is that these seem to be relatively fuel-efficient vehicles. Maybe these were only hybrid vehicles, or maybe vehicles are more fuel-efficient now than I realized. Another way to look at stem and leaf plot, another way to look at quantitative data is something called stem and leaf plots. This is done in a very similar manner. The idea is we just take the last digit of each number, in this case this would be the tenths place, and essentially chop it off or separate it, and that becomes what's called the leaf, and then every digit before that becomes the stem. We see here that there's like a 8 over here next to this 31. That represents the number 31.8, and we know it's 0.8 because of this leaf unit here. It's being described as the leaf unit being 0.1. So over here next to the 32 we see four numbers, 5, 7, 9, 9. That represents four different vehicles. One of them has an MPG rating of 32.5 miles per gallon, another one at 32.7, and then two of them at 32.9, since there's two nines over here. And again, we still see the same shape, where there's kind of like a one hump, and actually we get a little bit better picture now that we see that the hump actually has a high point around 36, 37, a little bit more exact than we got before. All right, so again, same kind of picture here, but now we're dealing with a histogram. A histogram, like a stem and leaf plot, just is essentially like just bars. In this case, each bar has a width of 1, so here's 30 to 31, 31 to 32, etc., and we just have the frequency of each group. Histograms, even though they're like bar graphs, they do have the feature that each of the bars must be touching each other, because you want to account for every single number, so there shouldn't be any gaps unless there's actually numbers missing. In addition to that, even though histograms look prettier, there is a disadvantage. A stem and leaf plot shows the same information as a histogram, only we can recover the very original data set, because all 100 cars are listed here, the value for every single car. Whereas with the histogram, we see that we have a bunch of cars between 35 and 36. Looks like we have about 11 cars, but we don't know the exact value of those cars. An advantage to a histogram over either the stem and leaf plot or the dot plot is both dot plots and stem and leaf plots, they can only be used if you have a relatively small sample, somewhere between like 30 and maybe 150 observations. Once you get too many observations, they just become a little overwhelming and difficult to read. But a histogram, you can use a histogram for thousands or tens of thousands of observations. You just, instead of putting frequency here, you might have relative frequency instead, or a percentage.